Trying to become a data scientist and don't know where to start? Well, this video is perfect for you because I am going to talk about how I would learn data science in 2023 if I were to start all over again. I did a version of this video in 2022 and I like to refresh it every year with my updated thoughts based on the industry trends in the data science job family. So in this video, I'm going to summarize 6 steps that I would take to learn data science. We would be talking about what research you need to do, and then we'll jump into what skill set you need to learn, followed by what do you need to do after you're done with all of that. As we go through the steps, I suggest you take notes. I'm gonna link down a Notion template below, which you can use when researching different data science roles, different data science job family, and for creating your study plan. Number one thing that I would do to become a data scientist in 2023 is I would research the role. When I started to learn data science, I heard that data science is the sexiest job family thanks to the Harvard Business Review, and I jumped in. I wish I had done the research, tried to understand the data science job family a little bit more to understand what encompasses the job family and what are the different options in there before I jump into one. In 2023, there are many roles within the data scientist job family, and I'm going to list a few of them. There is data engineer, machine learning engineer, data scientist, product data scientist, data analyst, just to name a few. So if you are just starting up and don't know anything about these job families, I would suggest that you read up on each of these roles and try to understand what they do before jumping into any of the roles that are in the data science job family. Because this step will give you actually a really, really good idea what the expectations of the role are and what you will enjoy doing. So let's say you have decided that you want to become a data scientist generalist. You can think of it as like full stack engineer who does backend, front end, the middle, and everything in between. You can think of it as like a full stack data scientist that does pretty much everything. They know statistics, machine learning, they know coding, they can take the business problem and apply data science to solve those problems and add value to the business. So let's say you've figured out that data scientist role is what you want to do. You're not done researching yet. What I would suggest you to do is go read the job descriptions for the data scientist role at different companies that you are interested in. As I mentioned in some of my previous videos, data scientist is a slightly difficult job family to be in because the definition for a data scientist is not well defined from company to company. So this is why you need to put a lot of attention on this step, because your study plan, your roadmap is going to look different depending on what companies and what specific roles that you're trying to target. Let's say Amazon is the company that you want to target and you want to become a data scientist there. You will go to the job description for the data scientist open roles at Amazon, and you will try to understand what are the skill sets required. Second, you will go to LinkedIn, look up people who currently work as a data scientist or have worked as a data scientist at Amazon, and try to look at those people's educational background. What did they study? And the type of project that they worked as a data scientist. Basically, we're actually doing this research, and we're basically actually doing data science here, statistics. We're basically collecting samples of people and trying to understand what are their educational history, what is the type of project that they do. This is also a good time to look at if there are like specific certificates that these people have, specific degree programs, specific boot camps that these people took that basically help them. So this will get you actually a lot of information. So let's say you have done your research where you're ready for the third step. The third thing I would do is I would learn the fundamentals of data science. You probably were not expecting to hear that because a lot of other advice that you have heard is telling you to start coding. I strongly believe that in order to be a data scientist, a good data scientist, you actually need to have a solid theory knowledge of statistics and machine learning before you get to the coding part. And there is a reason why. The coding languages is a way to apply data science. They're not the data science itself. You can ask any data scientist who is currently working in the industry or is going to school, you can ask them like, what is data science? They will tell you data science is pretty much statistics, domain knowledge, and machine learning knowledge. So that's why it's important for you to build those fundamentals before you start getting into coding. Now here, one thing I would say that if you hate coding, then I would not pursue data science because data science does require coding. And if you have never coded in your life, in that case, I would suggest you to try out coding first before you jump into the theory. But theory is so, so important, and it basically builds the foundation for data science. So I would suggest you to learn statistics and learn the machine learning fundamentals before you jump into coding. And we're doing this step, but we're not gonna go too deep. We're gonna go at the high level. You're gonna try to understand what statistics actually is. You're gonna try to understand what machine learning actually is. So before you jump into the next part, let's say if somebody comes and asks, what is the difference between linear and logistic regression? You should be able to explain it. That's the level of knowledge that I suggest you to have before you jump into the coding part. The coding part would actually, when you apply the knowledge, you will actually get to learn statistics and machine learning much more. But for the initial learning period, I would suggest to stick to the fundamentals. Learn statistics, mathematics, and machine learning. So these are the three areas that I would suggest to build your fundamentals on. So here is how I would approach it. For math, I would be very comfortable with linear algebra. For statistics, I would get pretty comfortable with probability, distributions, hypothesis testing, Bayesian versus frequency test. So those are basically the basics in statistics. The third, I would suggest you to go into machine learning. And machine learning, try to understand what are the types of machine learning there is. Supervised, unsupervised, reinforcement. And then within each, try to understand what is a regression, what is a logistic regression, what is classification, what is decision tree. We're not going too deep, but we're understanding it enough that we can explain theoretically what they are, because we're gonna go back to it again.
Now, a word from our sponsor, Simply Learn.
If you're trying to start your career in data science and looking for a structured program, the Simply Learn Data Science Bootcamp might be a good fit for you. The program is developed in partnership with Caltech University, which is ranked number 9 in the US, and in my opinion, gives it credibility. It's a 6-month cohort-based bootcamp with 25 plus hands-on projects. Going through the curriculum, I really like that it starts with building foundation in statistics and machine learning, and then jumps into coding and teaches Python, SQL, and R with hands-on experience in 3 different domains. Also, I really like that it focuses on interview prep, which is much needed because we all know data science interviews are not easy. In this program, you will learn from global data science faculty who have combined 40 years of experience. The cohort is starting soon and has limited seats. I'm linking the bootcamp below. Check it out. It might be a good fit for you. Now, back to the video. So let's say you build your theory. You have a solid foundation in statistics, machine learning. Now, it's time for you to go to the next step, which is learn to code. There are many languages that you can learn for data science. For the simplicity's sake, I would suggest to start with SQL and Python. I personally started with SQL and R. R has a very steep learning curve, and it's not as intuitive as Python. But R has a lot of ready-to-go statistics methods available to you that you can use for doing like a very quick analysis. But R cannot be productionized, whereas Python can live in a production environment. I would suggest you to start with Python and SQL. Python is super intuitive, and as an industry, I have seen that Python has actually been taking off because it's easy to understand by everybody involved in the project, including software engineers and data scientists. For learning SQL and Python, SQL, you can go with any learning resource for learning SQL. It's pretty straightforward. You just need to understand how to join different data sets, inner, right, left, self joins, which is like a weak point for me, how to do subqueries, how to do window function. For Python, now, there are a lot of courses that are out there for learning Python. Here, I would like you to pay special attention to focus on learning Python that is specific to data analysis. For example, there are several libraries that are focused on data science and data analysis and machine learning, such as Pandas, NumPy, scikit-learn, matplotlib. Just be mindful when you're picking your learning resource for Python. Make sure that it has a focus of data science, because there's a ton of learning material out there that teaches to software engineers and non-software engineers. I would suggest you to focus on Python that is more targeted toward data science. At this point, you have a really good understanding of fundamentals of data science, which is statistics, machine learning, math. You have coding knowledge, which is SQL and Python. Now, is actually it's time to apply the skills that you have learned so far and turn it into a project. There is a possibility that while you were learning all those things, learning Python, learning SQL, through whatever learning resource that you use, you probably already did the projects. So you have like some hands-on experience. But this step is specifically to build your portfolio and to get you more hands-on knowledge on how to do things. Start building your project portfolio. And remember the first step that we did, or the second step that we did, where we were looking at different people on LinkedIn who are working at your target company in that role. If you have already written down what type of projects that they do in their role as a data scientist, this will give you actually a very good idea of what type of projects to target, what kind of focus areas that you need to have in your project portfolio. If you're looking for data, there are actually a lot of free resources available to you which has tons of data and problem sets that you can use to build your project portfolio. Listing a few, including Kaggle, Google Data Search, US Census Bureau, and you don't have to be limited to the data that is available in this platform. You can actually make your own data. For example, you can look at your purchase history on your credit card, download that data, turn this into a data science problem, and do a project on it. Identifying your purchase trends, for example, how likely are you to buy a coffee if it's raining? What I'm trying to say here is like you can look at different data set, make your own problem, and try to build projects around it. Build at least 5 projects, get your data from Kaggle, Google Data Search, or make up your own data. Target a domain that you are interested in, but also a domain where you want to get into. For example, if you want to be a data scientist in e-commerce, then you would pick a data set that is related to that and solve a problem that is related to e-commerce. I would also suggest, if you have the option, is to build an online project portfolio, link it on your LinkedIn, link it on your resume, and build a GitHub portfolio. This is optional. I personally didn't do a GitHub portfolio, but if I were to do it again and I don't have any experience, I would build a GitHub portfolio so recruiters can look at it and they have additional information on my skill set that they probably don't have on other candidates who don't have a GitHub portfolio. The reason you're learning, trying to become a data scientist, is to get a job. If you are doing it just because you're curious, like, that's great. But most people who are trying to become a data scientist, they want to get a job. So the 6th step that I would recommend is to prepare for interviews. And the reason I say this is because a lot of people discount how much work interviewing is. Knowing the skill versus doing it in an interview setting where you are under a pressure environment and you have to answer in a time-constrained manner. I would start practicing on a platform like LeetCode or Start a Scratch. I'm going to link it below. And that is for SQL and Python. And then for your fundamentals and your theoretical knowledge, I would start mock interviewing and start practicing with a friend, have them ask you questions. So that way you are ready for the interview itself. I've created a detailed video on how I prepare for interviews and what is my process. You can go and watch it here. I'm going to link it somewhere here. It goes in a lot more detail than I'm going in this video. So hopefully by the end of this process, you are able to go into an interview and perform to get a job offer. Now, that being said, I do want to mention that over the last few years, given that there's so much interest in the job family, it has become more and more competitive. So don't be discouraged if you don't get your job on the first try. So this is the process that I would use if I were to learn data science all over again. Do any of these steps resonated with you, surprised you? Let me know in comments. With that, thank you so much for watching this video, and I will see you in a different one. Have a beautiful day.